with chlorine trifluoride aboard. It has been offloaded and awaits you in Cargo Bay A. I need everyone involved with the transfer to review procedures and protocols at the start of their shift today, as you will be the lucky individuals that get to escort these containers to fuel storage. I don't think I need to remind you what chlorine trifluoride will do if you mishandle it. Just ask Ina. Stick to procedures and everything will be fine. Once it's secured, I'll give you all the rest of the shift off. You're welcome, Gerard Wildman. Dr. Igwe, temporary assignment. Mr. Wildman, Dr. Dewo Igwe assigned you to your area temporarily. I've encouraged him to stay out of your way and avoid interacting with Cargo Bay personnel. There are some incoming materials I'd like him to handle directly. This is confidential and he answers directly to me. So, if you have any issues, please contact my office. Thank you, Dr. Sylvan Bellamy. Cool. Well, Wildman's desk, huh? Star Vandal, spatial delivery. Pretty sure I've read that one twice. Pretty sure. Ooh, filing cabinet with 9mm bullets. Prisoners of Space Industry. Excerpt from Chapter 1 of Prisoners of Space Industry by Thaline Cross. Working aboard a space station like Talos is comparable to working on Earth. Employees tend to forget that they are in space and adapt very well. By contrast, a trove of psychological and behavioral data has been compiled by a decade-long study of Pythias employees. The Pythias facility sits deep in a crater in the lunar pole, permanently shadowed and surrounded by kilometers of ice. Beneath Pythias is a vast network of cramped tunnels wherein helium-3, hydrogen, and platinum are mined. This is a dark, cold, and often terrifying workplace cut off from the warm glow of Earth, which extracts a heavy toll, and often fatal toll, on the crew. Yeah. Being...
The officers collected those supplies. They're not for you. That food is being rationed. Who knows how long we'll be here?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm the captain. I am the captain now. Food and supplies. I've gathered all the supplies I could find, and it looks like we have enough food to hold out for several days as long as we are rationing. Here's an inventory. 3 bananas. Use these first. They are going bad. 2 pomegranates, some dim sum, cookie box, fish sticks, Ugani rolls, udon noodles, veggie blend, jellied eels, gross, caviar. We have all the water we need as long as the fountain keeps working. Thanks for the food, fuckers. You know, with
if
the number...
If only I could have put out the fire. It's contained, but I could have done more.
Girl, I want to hit you with this wrench so fucking hard. Just because
I had reached the power
seeing someone alive just bothers me. Not because you are who you, like, are. I got a murder boner.
Rose here. I've covered Bay 1. Nothing. How solid is your source?
Solid. Sweep the area again. Word is the smuggler is moving the contraband out during the next cycle.
Maybe if you got me one of those fancy helmets from Psychotronics, that'll speed things up.
Not funny.
Sorry.
Sweep the area again and report back. Elazar out.
Let's see. Recycle this gun? I imagine you people could probably use this weapon. I'm gonna dismantle it and use the spare parts to fix turrets. Yeah, the turrets at least fight.
God, watching those things move makes me sick.
Hey, Alfred.
What is it doing? Oh my God, did it?
I think I'm gonna be sick.
It just made another one of those things, like it pulled it right out of Enoch's corpse.
Ugh, corpse? Maybe. I don't know, maybe it saved him.
Wow, there's a lot of bullshit down in here.
Does it look like it? Sam, promise me you'll kill me if I...
Dreamweaver! Phantom Genesis 2. Weakness. No way.
She got us this far. We're safe in here.
For now, I'm going to check the perimeter.
Yeah, almost. I want more of that thermal phantom. Baby, don't leave me! stand there so I can, you know, scan you, Thermal Phantom. Killed the last one pretty damn fast that I don't think I got a chance to scan him one whatsoever. Yeah. Oh, I'll get my chance with you. Or I'll wait for you, Psycho. Oh, wait. Damn. He turned around at the last moment. If you would have come around this corner, you would have had that whole run there, and we'll probably be able to get a full scan on him. I do have the scan faster upgrade. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Come on, don't. Yes! Thermal absorption. Weakness, psychic. Ah, it's too bad I'm putting no points into psychic. Okay, now I'm stuck on people. God, please. And what do we have in here? Some bio waste in the medical bay. I cleared out that other area if you guys, you know, don't want to hide. Grab that med pack if you don't mind. Ooh.
Requesting new operator.
I do love a new operator. Nothing else to loot.
Diagnosing.
Yeah, just a little bit of diagnosis make me feel good.
All better. You can fill out a service questionnaire at the front desk.
I won't. But it's cute that you think I have the care to do such a thing. These asteroid fragments. I imagine I just get some interesting material out of that. The Starbender Cycle, Book 5, Crown of Tumbleweed. Excerpt from Book 5, The Starbender Cycle by Fletcher McMavin. Trevor, get up. Trevor lifted his head to find the source of the voice. His brain was foggy and he hadn't heard this one, his old name, in what felt like ages. Here he was, Ka'oil, and the diminutive cliff dwellers of the Danthor called him King. Rolling out of his royal coat, he allowed his eyes to focus on the figure silhouetted in the doorway to his royal cave. He knew that uniform, he knew that stance, and disapproving glare. Empress Tormerlene, how did you find me here? The subdermal vacuum? What the fuck? The subdermal vacuum adaptron we had you install came with a beacon. I tracked it here after beating Mercy to death and taking back the prism. I still need a crack pilot I can trust, assuming you're through playing royalty with these timid rock humpers, that is. Trevor untangled the tumbleweed crown from his matted hair and reflected on his responsibilities to his meek and brethren followers. Yeah. Just one thing before I go. Trevor picked up his ceremonial chihuahua stick and strode out into the light. Man, someone had a good bit of fun writing that shit. Anything of use hidden in the corners, or was all just whatever was in the toolboxes? How about the top shelf? I don't know how I fit in this shelf, but sure. Shipping and receiving. You are a man holding a gun. I will get to you in just 1 second. I just need to steal everything I can get my hands on. It's like I have sticky fingers. Oh. Crew manifest. Always entertaining. Always fun.
Did you do something to the escape pods? Did your brother?
I don't believe I did. My brother, I cannot speak for 100%. I don't know if he did either, because
so
if he did...
So you came this way, only to get back into Talos?
Well...
The only way in is through the door to Cargo Bay B, which is filled with those creatures that your brother insisted couldn't escape confinement. Kind of like you. I'm the only one with the code. It's yours if you can help us secure the firepower we should have had when assigned here. The Eradicator Turret Fabrication Plan. My men told me power's been restored to the Fabricator.
Girl, you got like a Klingon head going on right now.
I was quick to underestimate you, Doctor.
Doctor.
That means all we need is the Turret Fabricator Plan. There's one in the safe in the security office, but the hull breach puts it out of my reach. Still, if you have a suit and are up for another walk, We could really use the additional firepower.
I have a good bit of firepower, but I don't mind being able to make turrets.
Just remember, the only thing that matters is how you treat the people that are still alive. Remember,
it's
the fabrication plan we want, not the reployer plan. Whatever the hell a reployer is.
Yeah, I'll get both of them. Survivor's account of the evacuation day one. I read this one before. Long time ago. The title, though, sticks out, so easy to remember. What do I have for neuromods I just picked up? Ooh, I'm sitting at 6 again. Okay. More upgrades for the glue gun. More leverage. Leverage has been fighting me for quite some time. Toughness. 200 health. Take longer to detect. Man, do I suck bad at stealth. Firearms. Increase damage to 150%. You know, the amount that I kind of rely on firearms. That seems good. Yes. There's always another way. Loading zone, turrets, gather supplies. So you want me to head back out there, hey? I just got in here. You people. Constantly just demanding. Ooh, you boys want to start a big fight, don't you? That guy's just eyeing me down. We got some bullshit out here. That's it for scanning on those. That's the best I got on Weavers. Backlash 3.
New psionic aptitude available.
Oh, 02. Wait, does that mean there's a Weaver outside now? Fuck, I'm not ready to fight a Weaver. Another one? I got lucky with the first one. And there's like one over there.
There must be a way to get some turrets online.
Oh, I have several turrets online. Just open up the door to the main cargo bay. It seems to be relatively safe. You guys probably sealed it off. Smeared it with feces or whatever people do in times of crisis. You didn't smear it with feces, compliment. Did you? What do we have here? Reployer. Exterior door welded. Mr. McGow, as a safety precaution, we have disabled critical machinery required to open the exterior door in Cargo Bay B. And, as added insurance, the door has been welded shut. If the bay is for storage only, then we want to be certain there can be no accidental opening. Restoring the bay door to full function will be practically impossible. Thank you. Unresolved guts incident. That's about it, eh? Hey, Anders, got your message about the shipment failure. I dispatched an engineer operator to check it out, and something weird happened. Telemetry shows it ran into some sort of energetic lattice work? The readings were unlike anything I've ever seen. Side effect of the psychotronic project? In any case, the operator was able to move through it and investigate, but shortly after it became unresponsive. I'm gonna have to get human eyes on it, but all our people are tied up with critical field transfer. When that's done, I'll send someone to check it out. Thanks. Catastrophic accident report. There was a blast in Cargo Bay A. Exterior doors ruptured. All the bulkhead doors automatically sealed, but several of my people are missing. Dr. Igwe from Psychotronics was in there, and he's gone as well. Ketra said she saw a floating orb drift over the cyclone or chlorine trifluoride container and detonate. Possibly some kind of static discharge, but all the dampers were activated. Secondary blasts went off not long ago in fuel storage, but I have that sealed tight and no one was in there. Something is going on. Nobody's calling me back. Let me know as soon as you get this. I'm going to take the rest of my people over life support as a precaution. Cage temporary storage. Open cage one, open cage two. Let's take a look at what's in these cages first before I start opening shit. Send someone to find a cutting torch. We need to get into these cargo cages and see what supplies are in here. Sarah. Oh, I'll find out how many supplies are in there. Hey, Austin, cool.
Yeah. Any luck with the eradicators? Would be a lot better than these cap guns Transtar assigned us.
How about you just let me in? There's like three. Well, eradicator turrets, huh? Those do sound real
nice.
These
Transtar PPN-8 pistols are mostly for show. They don't do much against the attackers. With the eradicator turrets, we have a chance.
I do like the sound of eradicator turrets.
Dr. Yu, were you up in crew quarters? Have you seen any sign of my wife, Nicole? Last I heard from her, she was on her way there. If you find her, can you help get her here? The thought that she may have become one of those creatures. I'm sorry, Dr. Yu.
It haunts you.
Forgive me.
Yeah, well, as long as the mission doesn't update that she's violently dead due to my actions or inactions, then yeah, but I'll take a look and see if I can find your wife. Sounds like a plan. So I have the locker code for there. Let's see if these utilities work. Open cage 2. And open cage 1. Need leverage. Okay. Even surrounded by all these people. Gotta check for mimics. You never fucking know. Weapon upgrades. I'm sitting on a couple of those. Ooh. Turret. Burton circuit. A little bit of that. And actually.
Attitude adjustment required.
Yes, I know. You need to change your attitude, little turret. Let's see, we'll just prop that here and expect a hell of a fight. Place two more turrets in the loading zone of Cargo Bay B. Oh, so you want a total of three. Well, I have a few there. Just want to hack this. Didn't mean to pick it up. And excellent. Now, this is my turret. Yeah, so if I could get these three, that would give me four and could progress, but that would be too easy now, wouldn't it? So, can't get through that, and this only leads me over to here to let me know that there's a Weaver watching that goddamn safe now. And everything has been studied quite effectively there. Okay, well, heading out for my spacewalk then.
Hello, are you
Was going on a walk one day. Yeah. Actually, back in the cargo bay, I'll be able to... Jeez, Ross, you seem like you're... A little wound tight there, bud. You may want to calm down. Let's see, recycle all the trash. Yes, good amount of materials. And dismantle. Any other duplicate weapons? No. Upgrade. Movement speed, don't care. Reload speed, not that big of a deal. Shotgun, how are you looking for upgrades? Guess could chuck one into recoil. And... reload speed's pretty good right now. I could throw the last two into that once I get enough neuromods to be able to upgrade the shotgun to max firepower. Then I'd be just fucking shredding dudes. Actually, how about you? Power 4 seconds, 4.5. recharge. Increase recharge and decreases drain. From a second and a half to a second and a quarter. I truly don't use it that much. Hmm. 88 rounds. Holy Christ. They're really prepping me for a fight, aren't they? Thought I saw something weird for a second there. Guess it was just my imagination. Then again, in this game, if you think you see something weird, you probably saw something weird. Yeah, this is gonna save anyways, once I get on the other side of the, cargo bay door. And I do still have that turret floating out there as well. That should help me good with the Weaver. At least it'll draw attention away from myself. That'd be great. Have the Weaver detected. Cargo Bay A. Always a wonderful place to visit. Is my turret? No. There's my turret. Oh, Christ. Came up to you a lot faster than I expected. Okay. Oh, there we go. No, don't float away. Okay. He died real easy. I think he took out my turret in the process, but he only took like 2 shotgun rounds. Okay. Reload that shotgun, 0G and 1, 2, 7, 4. No, I want. And I hear bullshit going on out here. Yes, I did.
We had those turrets earlier. Keep an eye out for materials to build them. Schematics half the battle. Once they're built, though, I can't wait to see what they do to our new friends.
You know what? Oh, yeah, that transcribe I picked up I never listened to.
Are you there?
Chief? Yes? Is there something wrong?
I wanted to speak to you about the most recent VIP visit. Leitner, the pianist.
Chief, if there were any problems, I checked the schedule, the roster. I did my best to make sure Igwe wasn't too... Igwe. Chief, I even had Leitner's cigarettes waiting.
You did an excellent job. In fact, Leitner praised you specifically. There'll be a bonus for you in your next pay cycle. Take Nicole out for a nice dinner, all right?
Yes, Chief. Thank you, Chief.
Ooh. I just see stuff glowing there. And I guess I did not pillage that while I was here. Turret will keep an eye on me. Is that ammo, liquor, and... Nope, just... fish sticks. Yeah. Rolls, and that. Hey, my radiation went down a significant amount from the, like, 70% I was staying at. God, that was annoying. And a little bit of used plastic. Any other flashy stuff going on around here? I did pillage this container already. Did I? No, I missed it? Wow, that was a hell of an oversight. Is there any other containers I missed? Didn't feel like I was rushing while I was coming through here, but I... That was a neuromod right there. Christ. Got those... That one up there. Got that one over there. Yep. Think I've, Of course, I forget to look at the little things, like... How to roll, and... So, both of them are to break, hey? Hmm. Well, that fight wasn't nearly as difficult as I thought it would be. Now it's just a quick run back to grab my turrets, and, yeah. Then big fight in that cargo bay. They want minimum 3. I can supply 4. And probably build a 5th just for a LARF. Like, you don't have the key card, do you? Is that why? You had to take the long way around, you chicken shit bastard? I guess I need to build. Well, wait, if I build them here with the fabricator, how the fuck do I get them over to the other side? Do I have to haul them? Like, is there not a... No, I can't. I don't understand. There is no fabricator on the other side of that door. And my maneuverability, there's no way I can make this whole thing just with holding a turret. There has to be a better way. Unless she gives me the schematic now, or the key card to be able to get through there. Without it, there's no way I can get a turret here. I can barely manage this shit without a turret. Actually. No, definitely need to grab and mount and... Yeah. Please give me a key card for that door. Because if not, then... Oh, shit. See? Tried to rush it, fucked it up. You know, there has to be an easier way. Let's get you.
Attention. Due to a catastrophic breach in Cargo Bay 1, all personnel are to avoid the area until repairs have been completed and safety checks confirmed.
Thank you.
Affected personnel will be contacted for temporary...
All right, woman. Let me go through the main door. If not, then you're not getting your fucking turrets. Sarah?
No turrets, no code. It's for our safety, and yours. We're not going anywhere, but that doesn't mean we don't have places to be. We need those turrets.
I know, I have them. Just open the damn door. Open cargo bay B. Back inside Talos 1, I need to get an army key. Fabricate your... No? First, I have to get through the cargo bay, but won't open the door unless I get her some turrets. As soon as the door opens, the Typhon will flood their way in. It's either that or find some other way to get the doors open. Now, it's not like I can hack my way through. It's way too high level for me. And I don't think there's a way to sneak through the other side. I just need to... I'm kind of surprised that I don't have the key card I need. Is that a Reployer? Hey, a Reployer. Cool. And... Worth a look in a book. Okay, you just need to calm down. You grab, then you lose it. I don't think... No, I don't believe I can get up there. Then again, I've been surprised of what I can fit in and get up into. No. Hello? Hi, Jessica. Log in with Reployer. If you need access to cages, don't tell anyone. It'll make me look stupid. Yeah, well, I already opened the cages. Actually, I should be able to get above this shit. I don't think that'll give me anything. And of course, that is the only way through there. I just need to be stronger. Could try mashing the code in the keypad, but that won't do anything for
me. Nothing will get past me.
That's what you say. You're probably going to be one of the first to die. No, cargo loading access 01.